Every now and again, even for Kay and Burton, a home comes along that is genuinely in a league of its own. And in spring 2013, it is Redcourt, an extraordinary estate in Armidale that is the most compelling story of history, culture, celebrity, and unwavering commitment to excellence. Redcourt will be launched to the market in early October in a campaign that is certain to capture the attention of the global marketplace. With such a magnificent story to tell, it's fitting that one of the nation's greatest storytellers, Jack Thompson, was chosen to narrate the film made about the Redcourt revival.
Redcourt is undoubtedly one of the finest family homes in the country.
But the celebrity firepower doesn't end there. When owner Adam Garrison bought the derelict estate in 2009 from the state government, he set about assembling what can only be described as a designing dream team to create the residence the likes of which this city has never seen. Overseeing kitchen design, the great chef Shannon Bennett.
So I took a snapshot then and there how I wanted my own kitchen to be designed if I owned this house, and that's the way that I looked at it. And for me, it turned out just exactly the way I wanted it. Redcourt really is a house for someone who has potential to really fall into the gastronomic world of Melbourne.
Art consultancy and the design of this extraordinary children's bedroom was given to none other than renowned artist David Bromley.
You know, my idea was, you know, for the room was, you know, maybe a room that, you know, Enid Blyton would have written The Famous Five in. It's a little bit of a portal into another world.
This music room and interior consultancy came from the talented designer Akira Isagawa, and famed photographer Earl Carter was chosen to shoot the finished product.
It was gobsmacking. It just was so, so beautiful. Because of the collection of old and contemporary that had been so perfectly merged together.
But Redcourt's association with great designers has been there since the very beginning, when original owner, prominent businessman Edward Yankin in 1887 engaged the city's finest architects, Reed, Henderson and Smart, to design a home befitting his place in society. The home passed through numerous owners before, like many great mansions of its era, passing into government hands, being used as a boarding house for music, dance and art students. By the time its current owner bought it in 2009, the one-time glittering mansion was virtually uninhabitable.
Only then did the painstaking restoration and refurbishment of this jewel of Victoria's architectural heritage begin.
In pure real estate terms, this property is extraordinary, sitting on around 3,500 square metres in Armidale and offering a swathe of individually themed living areas designed to entertain on the smallest or grandest scale. A suite of magnificent accommodation highlighted by an extraordinary main bedroom suite and, of course, that incredible Shannon Bennett kitchen, plus a roll call of upscale amenities such as a gym, steam room, flower room, fully equipped bar and a basement cellar. In the grounds, the former coach house has been transformed into self-contained guest quarters, and the magnificent gardens include an organic vegetable patch, and on the site of the former full-size tennis court, there now lies a stunning croquet lawn and pavilion. And as I mentioned at the top of the story, Redcourt will be introduced to the market in early October. The campaign will be headed up by Kay and Burton directors Michael Gibson and Ross Savas, although on this occasion the leading Sydney agency Christie's has also been invited to join the program to ensure this house is set exactly as it should be, a home of national significance.
The Kay and Burton Report, proudly partnering with NAB Business Banking.